like you said, the question marks, right? Like those two guys didn't play any pro CS before now. Very young players. I think Six only like 17 years old. Vice maybe like 18 or 19. So definitely got to see what they can do, as they're repping a pretty big brand here. They have big shoes to fill with who they had before.
They got real big shoes to fill. We'll see if they can do it. Pistol round starting now on Overpass. We've got TSM on the CT side, which will consist of Vice, Stick, Semphis, Automatic, and FNS. Vice going for the kit and the smoke, so utility player there. On the Terra side, we've got Team XAA. That's Happy Cheetos, Maka, Josh RT, Cutlass, and Sayonara with a great Steam icon. He's also going to start off the round. He'll bring down Vice with a headshot. Semphis now on fallback. He's getting caught, somehow evading a bit of damage and able to get out of there alive. Still, though, CT's a man down, not left. Not great of a position, and now Team XA will just spread out and take full map control. Actually, executing into B pretty quickly. Six got two sick headshots. We'll try to avoid that going further. Sayonara now into the site. He takes Sick out of Graffiti, but people pushing into pit here, and one coming up this catwalk. That's FNS now in Graffiti. Brings down Maka. We've got Sayonara holding out around the support column. Trying to do his best. Support there at Sandbags. That's Cutlass, but it's going to fall, and that's everybody. TSM take the pistol.
Yeah, really well done there from Sick of Graffiti to kind of get that into a winnable situation for his team with a couple of kills on those crossing into the site. And then obviously Finesse on the retake, a big part of it there with two kills as well. So well done from TSM. They win the round, you know, pretty convincingly, I'd say, on that retake. But they do allow the bomb plant, so obviously XAA going to be able to take a save here and then get those AKs out in round number three. You do see a couple of SMGs in play here for Symphys and FNS, but Automatic and Sick and Vice all getting rifles, anticipating those AKs coming in round three. So this one should probably be a quick one, and I would expect TSM to not have too much trouble with it. So you are going to see XAA gathering up a lot of players here towards stairs, which could lead to a mid hit or just rerouting to short B pretty fast. So let's see what they want to do.
Maka straight out of the stairs, Symphys and Vice with a crossfire set up between short and within the bathrooms. Did pretty well. Now Vice pulls out the silenced USP and like a ninja gets two quick headshots, third kill on the Cutlass. 4K overall, so he's got a big round for him. Some money building up, and TSM easy under the 2-0, but the plant did go down, and now it's XAA, well, on the first round, of course, but they've got enough money for the rifle in round three.
Yep. As they buy down all the way to zero, so they get everything that they possibly can into this round, which, you know, of course includes a lot of AKs as well as utility. Vice actually gets a little bit of a run boost here, oddly enough, so he'll actually get stairs a little bit faster than normal, but he takes a peek and he gets absolutely crushed there by Josh RT, so already a casualty being suffered here.
Nice shot by Semphis. Again, forward aggressive control to middle. Pretty much the name of the game on Overpass. And, you know, it can make it a pretty tough CT side if you're playing ridiculously good aimers. Even though with Semphis getting that kill, that was actually to get the situation back to a 4-on-4. In which Team XAA will still be more or less favored. Although, always a little bit less so on Overpass, just because of how fast those CT rotates are. You really can't juke the CTs. And Josh RT did take quite a bit of damage. He's down to just 20 HP now. Everyone with the smoke, so if they group up, they will have everything they need to set and execute onto one of these bomb sites.
Yeah, you'd imagine so. Cutlass already sitting here outside Monster. Josh RT working through spawn to join up with them. Same with Sayonara and Maka. As Maka will stay stairs, though, maybe he'll just look to cut off some rotates if anyone's going to push mid and try to flank that way or just be able to assist from short B. But it definitely seems like XAA want to attack this site. You see them setting up some nades now. Six is pretty much left alone here. He'll actually take a peek at Monster, grabs a kill on the Cutlass, disrupting this execute a little bit. It's going to give him some information, and that means Automax will be able to start rotating over here.
Yeah, I think that disrupted that execution a lot of bit, and now Sick on the support column, lining them up, and even finding the fourth. So, we talked about Vice and Sick in the early game. Vice picks up a 4K, but his round was Eco Cobra, so it counted for a little bit less. But Sick onto the first rifle. After Semphis evens it up, Sick kills everybody else. So, very well done over there in B.
Yeah, I mean, he just, you know, pretty much held that on his own. Just some good rifle work there from Sick to shut that down in the end. We are going to see XA, of course, now just on the pistols. Looks like they just have a couple of flashes and one smoke. Looks like they just want to rush B here. We already see four players working their way through short in the construction, and they will head stand back. Sick and Finesse will have to hold here, and so far, Sick carrying over from the last round, doing pretty good. Automatic rotating in it now also, and this has been absolutely dealt with. No plant coming in as well, so TSM up 4-0. XAA, though, will be able to buy in this next round, so now we'll see another full gun-on-gun round. Kind of see where this is headed.
Well, Sick is just being fed some kills over there in the B site. Got 9 and 2 now, picking up, I think, what was it, another 2 or 3 as he's at the headshot ledge, sprays him down as they come in through catwalk with just upgraded pistols, no armors, into another rifle. My game's having a really hard time in that upper tunnel. I just have, like, a giant white spot through the entire map right there. Things have gone well.
Yeah, we see a little bit of an aggressive setup here. Vice has pushed all the way upper park. He's going to be set up with Simpus, who has the op automatic inside bathroom. So they definitely have a huge emphasis on putting some pressure on the forward position at the A bomb site here with three players. So Mac, who's been kind of playing a rotating position, is going to dedicate pretty heavy to A to kick this one off and make it rewarded for here. You definitely see XAA gathering up here at middle. I mean, they're pretty much in a default setup at this point. One stairs, one B, three working the park.
Oh,
Mac will catch one.
Well, at least Maka's there for the trade out. Automatic was the one person working alone. He pushes up into the bathroom to control that and short, and there was a double presence at long with Vice and Sempthis. And now Vice pushing out past the sign with the happy little children on it. He'll get a kill onto Maka. Now it's 4 versus 3. Finesse and Sick controlling out here inside of construction. Sick with a pretty awesome spray down. Gonna net him 2 more frags to be 11-2, and it's 5-0 in Team XAA. Looked like this is the first time they've seen Overpass in their life.
Again, I had never seen them play it before tonight. I mean, I don't know if, like I said, they may have played it in the ECA Premier, one of their like best of one matches there, but they certainly never played it at all during placement. Not sure if it's because their opponents banned it a lot, or you know, if it's just them approaching a new map to pick. I know they definitely never picked Overpass in placement when they had the opportunities to do so. So, yeah, didn't have any idea what they'd be able to do, and right now it hasn't been much, right? Team Solo Mid, this is their first official match on this map. So far, the CT side seems to be faring quite well for them, as they should be able to go up 6-0 here in just a few moments.
Yeah, but every time we say that, and it's not even going to be a rifle round, right? I bet Team XAA, they know we're talking about them. Their ears, their noses, they're burning, or whatever the saying is. We'll just run over them with Tech-9s. And last, of course, Sick still on the B site, or this time automatic on the little railing behind the site box, going to grab a quick 3. Sempthis stealing a kill from Sick. Automatic finally falling. Happy Cheetos, though, with that Tech-9. He's got 2. He's going to go for more. It's Vice and Sempthis up. M4 and up. Bomb down a little bit forward in front of Happy Cheetos. He can't really get to it that easily. And taking long-range battles with the Tech-9 here, not really a great position. And yeah, Vice will put him out of his misery.
So, I mean, that round was actually a little bit expensive there for TSM, and they lost 3 members in the process of that round. So
the Tech-9s.
Yeah, I mean, the Tech-9s did come through, but it doesn't really hurt TSM so much. They still have a lot of money banked up there. I mean, Sipis with an op still has 10K. FNS is sitting on $7,300, $6,200 on Vice. So they're certainly not hurting for money anytime soon. XA are going to have to string together several in a row before they're finally going to put any real economic pressure on TSM. As again, we are going to see a very aggressive A setup here from TSM. Simmons and Vice both pushing downstairs. Simmons will leave with the op, gets smoked off,
oh,
not taking the shot.
Shot.
Oh, he only gets a leg shot, but he's able to get away. Okay. And Vice is here to support him. He's going to repeat with that CZ. Taken down. It's a one-on-one trade here in the stairs.
There's almost a TK with the nade that went in there as well. Man, he didn't know it, but when he had him lined up in the smoke, they were lined up. If he had shot, he would have got 2 kills with an op through his smoke. Instead, gets pretty unlucky as he finally sees one. They jump, he shoots him in the leg, and it all turns into a 4 versus 4. Now back in the upper tunnels, all the terrorists taking the bomb back over to Playground, where Automatic is already pushed up to. Powerful position, unless he's caught off guard, which he is, but he will spot the bomb.
Yeah, I was just about to say Animac has a lot of information with this play, but now he's gotten caught, so information denied, and it's a 4-on-3. Vice is still going to be here. Sick has actually begun to rotate, so Finesse will anchor over towards that B-bomb site. Does spot Cutlass. They exchange a bit at Monster, but Cutlass just going to back off. Probably join up with this team here very soon, who are definitely looking to hit A now. They're starting to dedicate well up long at this point. the vice here at the bathrooms. We'll have to make a play because Six not real sure. He's kind of rotating back and forth. Cutlass is doing a pretty good job at putting a little bit of pressure at B, making Six second guess what's going on here. A lot of pressure on Vice at this point.
Oh, Finesse gonna grab that kill onto Cutlass, 3-on-3. A couple members low on both teams. Molotov could be well placed. Actually, not well placed on the wrong side. And XAA will smoke off Bank and the cross. Vice now that Molotov, he'll just push on through. And Happy Cheetos had to hurt that damage go out. Vice landing him up, nearly gets another. That's Maka surviving in the bathrooms. His location is known, and he doesn't actually quite know where Sick or FNS. He knows that one's in the site. Now hearing footsteps, he might be able to identify that two of them are there. They're going to try to peek in at the same time, and they will not be successful. They were both too low, pretty much one bullet to each of them, and Maka will be able to clutch that one out.
Yeah, really nicely done there by XAA. I actually thought Vice did okay with that incendiary. It was so that he could discourage anyone from pushing that side while he focused on the other side. I think that was the intention of it. He got a couple of kills, too. Just in the end, though, he did get taken out, and then it was a 1v2, and Maka just coming up with it there. So, really nicely done from XAA. They've so far really handled this aggression at A from TSM very efficiently. It's really just been them getting shut down at B, which is the cause of a lot of their round losses. We're going to see Finesse try to get aggressive this time on stairs. Tempest is actually going to take his op over to long B, so just kind of being a bit dynamic with that op placement.
Just go,
we do see some teams do it.
Oh man, you got to feel so bad. They put two nades into that position, expecting someone to have pushed up, but you know, behind a little corner, and Finesse takes no damage and is able to get, what, one kill out of that. Now 3-on-3 as Josh RT finds a kill. Vice still holding on at the bathrooms here, trying to watch the cross, but hard to hold on to both those angles when it's just one person. So Vice operating alone back in the site as the last line of defense is Semphis at half HP with that op. Looks like he's just thrown out a smoke. I wonder where it's gone and automatic over in B, but starting to maybe move about.
We got ourselves a 3-on-3 here as XAA are once again gathering up for a B execute. They've had a heck of a time getting in here, but it's mostly been due to the great work of Sick, but he's already gone. So the wait's going to be on Unimatic because he's the only one here now. Sempus is a pretty short rotate away, and even Vice is a pretty poor position on stairs to flank through to sandbags pretty quickly. But this initial contact, Unimatic's going to have to, you know, at least get a kill, stay alive, something. He does get the info, but like I said, he's got to stay alive for this rotate to set in.
Uh-oh. The spray down, and the AK will win. Wow, Sempus actually so close to seeing that man planting in the site. We'll take a shot through the box. Not sure if that connected or if Josh was already low, but down to 11 now. Vice going to try to go up from sandbags. I don't know if they realize that Josh Ortiz jumped into the pit. Vice takes one out of the canal. We got one more in Monster that I'll have to deal with. He expects it, but he's unable to win out. Maka will hit the op shot. And here's Sempus with that CZ long range. Josh was low. Op versus op battle now. It's what everyone wants to see in Counter-Strike. He'll bait the shot out. He goes in and hits it. Well done to Sempus. 3k on the round, and they will win it. Oh, maybe not. Trying to find a kit. Can't find one. Decides to get on the bomb. He's got the time. Gonna be close.
Down to the wire, but yeah, I think he does, in fact, have it there in the end. So just, I mean, that was just really well done from Sempus. I think he 1v3'd that. So that was just a raw individual effort there from Sempus. And again, even while TSM has struggled in a lot of these games that we've watched, like against Renegades and Winter Fox, it's been Sempus who has still done pretty well individually, and while he's not top fragging this particular map thus far, that was a big impact play there from him. It, you know, it got them back another round, it reset XAA's economy. Now you can see they're just on a Tech9 force buy because of that, so definitely pulling his weight here. As we are going to see XAA actually going for a pretty heavy push into middle. Finesse and Sick both on the stairs, getting held off. It's going to be awful for them trying to get back up, but they're getting a couple of kills.
I like how Finesse played that. He's like taking a couple shots, gets his kill, falls back, and then when he's falling back, they go in for the peek, and there's a man there with an MP9 ready to unload. And I actually thought that was going to be way more dangerous for Team XAA, but then again, I constantly underestimate Tech9s in this game, and I have no idea why. They land some quick headshots, and just like that, it's into a 3-on-3.
Definitely traded efficiently there, XAA did. Though Cheetos is certainly low on HP, so he's a little bit vulnerable, but they're going to work around towards B. So I guess they're going to run kind of a similar play to last time when they had a 3-on-3, which is basically just, like I said, automatic, kind of alone at first, waiting for a rotate. We see Simmons and Vice both have fallen back in A site, so they will have that quick rotate that Overpass grants you. XAA do have a couple of smokes still in play here and a few flashes, so they might be able to get in here and B and plant the bomb before the rotate can really set in. And from there, we'll just have to see what they can do.
Well, Automatic's been pretty good over at this B site, generally getting himself a kill. Thought he would have got that one since Cheetah's was so low. I mean, even if a bullet grazes him, he's going to go down. Good smokes, actually a bit of a gap allowing Automatic to run by, and wow, I think they thought they were way too safe with those smokes. They weren't watching that angle at all, and Automatic, well done, goes in with 3k. And we do have to get a correction. Senpis actually 1v2'd that last round because okay. I think it was Automatic that killed that one man in the canal.
That's true. My apologies there. TSM now up 8-1. XAA do get the bomb plant, but they invested a lot of money into that Tech 9 Forest buy, so they can't really reap the benefits so much of that money bonus from the plant. So they're pretty much stuck here again with an even less of a Forest buy than they had last time. So this is a great chance for TSM to just extend that lead even more, as they're already well out in front, exactly where they want to be on a map like this.
Man, this has been pretty crazy. Between Automatic, Sick, and Vice, there have been so many rounds where they're just getting multiple kills, one after another. This one, you know, kind of doesn't count because there's no armor and just some pistols, but even still, like, Sick runs into a couple of them and kills them all. And even on the rifle rounds, like, Automatic going unchecked at B, able to get two kills before anyone even reacts to him, and then he finds the third.
Yeah, I mean, Automatic and Sick have both had multi-frag rounds over on the B-bomb site. I think Six had two rounds where he's got two or three kills on a hold at B on a Matic. He had that one two-kill round that you're talking about, as well as a round prior to that where he had a few. So yeah, they've definitely locked B-bomb site down pretty well. I mean, the only person who's really even struggled a bit is Finesse, but he's been one of those guys pushing a lot and just kind of getting caught, but Team Solomon has always seemed to recover pretty well, as this time around, Finesse will get that opening kill. We see a little bit of a boost here from Automatic. I haven't seen this much. This is kind of newish.
That's cool. Yeah, I've not really seen that used either.
I've seen it the other way.
I always jump spotted, but I've never really thought to like put a smoke down and then go boost to it, which is why I'm not a pro player.
I've seen Terrace boost it to peek in. And I mean, I guess I have seen CT's boosted before, but not at that specific spot to be able to spot the tunnels like that. It's pretty neat.
Also, so early in the round, too. Like, they immediately pushed down there.
That's very true.
Used that smoke. That was actually a Terra smoke that was there, so they just quickly adapted. And oh my gosh, Senphis, please shoot. The Vakening. We saw that lock, Senphis. You can't hide from us.
Got you. Gonna be on Reddit. Especially for someone who's so outspoken against aim locks. We got you, Senphis.
Made over into construction and not. Oh, no one taking too much damage from that. Fire onto water. It's like the end of Free Willy. Reference game on point. And no, oh, they're Sick. Nearly getting a triple spray down, but just does get the first. That could have been dangerous. And now Senphis missing some shots here.
Both
he knows we're onto him.
He's
just trying to whiff some shots. Oh, there's another one!
Oh, man. What's happening here to Senphis? He was hitting a lot of nice shots really this half, but he's whiffed now three. Should have had two kills. This should have been already like a 2v1. Now it's a 2v2 thanks to Vice. He's going to be pushing into the site here. There is still one sandbags, one over towards the corner at Monster. They do have a kit onto Senphis, so they still have time to try to play this one out so they can find Senphis. Almost taking his teammates out there. We'll win that fight. We're about the sandbags pushing. Can't respond fast enough. So XAA finally will put a second round on the board, but it's not going to be any easier for them this round. I mean, still plenty of bank over there on TSM. Meanwhile, they do need to worry about their money being reset again. They have to rebuy quite a lot since they came down to a 1v1.
That they do. I don't see what, I mean, that's two wins, one-off wins. Well, maybe not quite on the second one. A chance for Team XAA to get two rounds in a row. But they were able to get one, then losing another three. Could be dangerous. This is an important round. Like you mentioned, TSM's money's got pretty tight now. Team XAA, of course, will be reset if they lose this, and then we'll be in very dire straits. And it's not starting off well on this B site. At least the smoke to cover the pit access was a little bit better this time, but even still, Finesse slips around it, hits the barrels, finds a kill. Josh RT, whoa, last bullet as he starts strafing. He's given up on the spray at that point, strafing out, still connects the headshot. He's fortunate to have even got one, and now it's Sayonara, one versus three. Josh RT is expressing some communication, some frustration there on the in-game comms, as it's 10-2.
As you said, a little bit better smoke cover there, but Finesse just pushing to such a powerful spot, those barrels, and getting a kill there. The initial B defense also held pretty firm, stayed alive for a good amount of time. That rotate was able to send in pretty quickly. And yeah, as we noted, XAA's money completely destroyed now. This round, they're pretty much on a full save except for a little bit of utility. Next round won't be much better, to be honest, so this very likely could be 12-2.
Oh, another spray down through Monster. And, yep. The attack on to B has not worked out again here.
I mean, not much you can hope for with just Glocks.
With just Glocks.
I mean, if they could have gotten some kills, it may have made Daze proud, but...
would have been a miracle.
Not gonna happen there. So, XAA... still not really a whole lot to work with. May consider forcing up, though, anyway, just because they need rounds. And they've been, at times, successful getting some opening kills with the Tech-9s. Like, but they've always got it into, let's say, 3v3 type situations quite a lot, and they've just never been able to convert those. TSM's been really good in those, like, situationals, as you would call them.
Woo! Tempest, he's hot right now. Did have a one round that was pretty suspect, missing a lot of shots. And actually, like if Tempus was on point that round, I don't think XAA, they'd still be limited to just one, and yeah, okay, he misses a shot there, but...
almost lined up two, though. That was almost a 2-for-1, the way that was playing out there, but just happened to, like, fit a bullet right in between both players. So now we do have a 4-and-4, but again, XAA, they've had a lot of these 4-and-4 and 3-and-3s, they just haven't really converted them. Like, TSM's always found a way to, like, work themselves back into the round and either have a successful retake, or someone like Sick or Unimatic will just have, like, a big 2k spray down to bring it right back to TSM. So XAA, they need to play this wisely because they need these rounds.
Oh, Vice peeking out from the bathrooms. We've seen him make some pretty big moves. Oh my gosh, that is timing strike.
Timing strike, dude.
The epitome of timing strike. Happy Cheetos is now sad at Cheetos. Hopefully he's got some Cheetos to eat. Although that's a messy snack if you're playing Counter-Strike. Josh RT, the same thing! And that's hard. I mean, at that point, you're a man down. You're trying to cover everything, and that's what happens. If you have to do the work of two people as one, you get timinged.
Yeah, I mean, TSM are an aggressive team. When you give them a one-man advantage, they will just kind of take these trade battles with you at that point. Since they know they're one-up, they'll just kind of peek you with two players at a time and kind of just always ensure that they're going to get something out of it. And that's what you see there. Pretty much everyone chiming in for the team except for Sick on that particular round. And so Cutlass will just try to save this AK for the last round of the half. But it's going to be 12-2 here in favor of TSM. And I mean, I guess we can't be terribly surprised. But yeah, I don't know. I can't say I'm that shocked. I guess that's all I can really say. I don't know. I don't know about you. I don't know what you expected to see out of this half, but...
Team XA, well, I expected not necessarily more from XAA. Well, at this point, from what we've seen, maybe a little bit more, but I also expected less from TSM based on what I've seen previously.
They've definitely had opportunities, on, like I said, on a few different 3v3s.
Yeah.
But, I mean, I said, I won't back down from what I said at the start of this broadcast. Like, I thought TSM would win, but I thought it would be still fairly contested within the maps. Not the case yet. Although T-side overpass is not the most forgiving thing in the world, although nor is the CT side. If you don't play this map, it can almost be harder, to be honest. But again, we have Team XAA in a 3v3. They were just having a little bit of a discussion. They say they need to do their due diligence and actually clear out all these corners, because if TSM realize they can get away with something, they're going to take that opportunity. They're the confident players. They're the ones that feel like they're the best in this server, and they're going to play with confidence. So Team XAA really need to check everything.
We are going to see Sick has pushed through short B. We're just going to rely on Simmons with this op just to hold A really passively while Automatic focuses on Monster, and Sick just continues to see if they're actually going to cross B through this short tunnel. I think Automatic will eventually drift away since Sick can actually watch them cross long. So that would make sense if he could actually get in a better position at A until Sick sees them actually pushing. And that's exactly what's going to happen. Automatic does begin to drift over towards this A side of the map. We obviously can see that's where XAA is headed. And they will meet Simmons' op as well as Automatic.
So, Clearing everything takes some time. They're starting to run out of it. Now, 20 seconds, executing onto this A site. Tempest holding with the op, and oh my gosh, again, timing! A little bit of bad luck, but also, of course, some skill from Semphis to realize that they're going to push there, and he knows his angles. Gets another one. Now, Cutlass, less than a 1 versus 2. Can't do it. That's a 13 to 2 half TSM. Dominant.
Going into the second half. I was hoping to learn a little bit about TSM's T-side on this map, but I may not get the chance on this particular game.
We might. There's still... You gotta
there's still
believe.
Some... Yeah, I guess I just gotta believe XAO1 pistol and make this interesting. Let's see.
And let's see, this was actually, this was the pick of Team XAA, too. So,
again, it was an odd pick, given the data we have, that they haven't really played it very much. And again, it's really hard to understand picks and bans from,
you don't
like,
have the, data.
The newer teams. And even, like, for TSM, it's hard to think about picks and bans with them, because they've only played a couple of best of threes so far, so...
Maybe they thought it was a weaker map for TSM, like trying to play to it a team's weakness rather than maybe their strengths?
Possible.
I don't know. Can only hypothesize at this point. But almost ready to go. Just one more player. Let's look at the stats. What do we got? Obviously, I'm assuming Vice, Sick, and Automatic had pretty big games. Yeah, Automatic, highest efficacy, 17 and 6. Sick, also 19 and 8. And then we got Vice at 14 and 7. Finesse and Semphis, the veterans, the old men of the team, each with 11 frags, but still quite positive. And when you win 13 to 2, there are only so many frags you can get. So everyone did well. Although Semphis had some questionable rounds, like some off shots.
I mean, he had some missed shots, but
then he also had a few where like he hit really nice shots, like that 1 versus 2, and even that last round at the A site to close out the half was pretty nice.
Yeah.
But consistency, Dust. That's what you need as an opper.
Yeah. All in all, it seems like TSM firing all cylinders tonight. Up 13-2 as we go into the second half here. XAA obviously in a must-win pistol round situation here to have any shot at bringing this map back in the striking distance. As even with the pistol round victory, trying to tie this thing up would still be quite a tall task. But we'll see what they can do here, as we are going to see a three-man aggression from XAA on to stairs. Very similar to what TSM did themselves. We're going to see TSM is gathering up for a big B hit, but look at this, they two push stairs and they push short as well, so TSM going to run straight into this as they try to push the short tunnel.
Oh, is this going to be dominant CT pistol rounds or what? Now Vice trying to go in and make a difference, but he peeks into three. He is bitten off more than he could possibly chew in one meal. Needed to spread that over an entire day. Automatic 1 versus 3. While making noise now, so his position is going to be known. Whoever that is over in bank, it looks like that's Maka. Is going to have heard this. You can see now the rest of the team coming up short A. Automatic, though, for a time, still out of 1 versus 1. He wants to get that bomb down for more money, but now off the short side, Josh RT will peek, deny the extra income, and extend the T side of Team Solo Mid.
Yeah, pretty dominant round there. I mean, it just still happened that what XA decided to do just completely hard countered TSM there. I mean, they were just trying to do a really fast push in the short B, but XAA had pushed three stairs, flanked all three of those players through door, and so, I mean, you're caught in such a tight choke point when running through that tunnel, and everyone's just gunning at you. Also had a player push sandbag, so literally four XAA members are just staring at you coming through the tunnel. It'd be very difficult to force your way through that, so XAA are gonna take that one. They're gonna see a bit of a force here from TSM, so Tech9s are going to be out, as well as the scout on Semphis.
Scout can be a deadly weapon on Overpass.
Indeed.
Don't see Semphis using too many tricks. There's a lot of jump scouting and boosted jump scouting positions that you can use to kind of crack open that B site, taking people out of windows, taking people out of barrels. But it looks like they're just going to grab it for its range purposes and take it long, and it's actually fallen to a scout. Semphis is upset about that one. But Maka, he did get tagged once, but he stays alive.
The rest of TSM here, just kind of sitting back towards bathrooms for the most part. Automatic has lurked around B for quite some time. Looks like we may even see TSM transition all their players that direction. Finesse leading the way now through stairs to door. So it seems like they do want to try to split this B bomb site after all. They don't have, well, they do have one smoke on Finesse. Maybe he can kind of block that short route or maybe put it in the window. I'm going to try to spill in here and see what they can do.
Well, Cheeto's in the pit. Was kind of setting up a similar angle to Josh RT, who is up in the window. But now flashes and smoke starting to disrupt that. Cutlasses are all the way back in graffiti. TSM, they bought up, really hoping they can get the bomb down here. Gotta be their goal, but they're facing heavy rotations. Sayonara coming out of the CT halls, another one still in graffiti. I don't know if they know about them both, or, well, they. It's actually just automatic. One versus three right now. He could do nothing. Three stay alive for Team XAA, which should be enough.
Whatever smoke finesse through there, horribly missed. Not that I know if that really had that much impact on the round. Maybe it could have helped them get a bomb plant if it would have landed better. But regardless, XAA, obviously, we're always in the advantage there. They're going to be able to take care of business. So now it's going to be 13-4. TSM, of course, going to be pretty much on a full safe here, except for a couple of upgraded pistols, but no armor, no utility. XAA getting a little bit aggressive here with Maka's scout to get some information, which he will find A fairly clear. There's already three towards B and Sayonara at stairs, so it seems like XAA will be well set up to rotate quickly to handle this.
I'm surprised Sayonara doesn't want to rotate through. Looks like it won't really be needed. Josh and Happy Cheetos. Oh, wow. Mappa just pulls out the USP to re-peek into the Deagle. Automatic gets a 1D. Might be the only kill they find. He's aiming a headshot ledge, so just shooting at the toes of Cutlass. Now 13-5, but this is what we really wanted to see. Finally getting into round 19. TSM not even able to get a bomb plant, though. So money not great. Limited rifle round, and it comes on round 4 of the half. So this is, again, another opportunity for XAA to get some rounds back.
Yeah, they're not going to have an op on Sippus or anything like that. They do have utility, though. They have five smokes. They have a few flashes. Looks like they're just going to gather up for a B-rush, which I guess would make sense given the limited utility. You can't really, like, fight for map control and then work into execute as well. So they're just going to pretty much commit to splitting B, sitting to lead the charge up sandbags. Right now they do spot Cutlass. They're going to exchange some fire. They have Cutlass down so low. They haven't killed him quite yet. Now they catch him with the nade out. Finally take him down. There's even a TK involved. Fire actually does kill a TSM member, so it's a 4-on-3 in favor of XAA right now after that chaos.
Yeah, so Sick thought he actually killed Cutlass. That's why they didn't even check it. Luckily, Happy Cheetos did the work for him, but he also killed quite a few of them. So TSM here on the T side, not able to show us much yet. Again, just trying to brute force their way into B. Zemphis now in Monster, trying to deal with Happy Cheetos. We'll continue that spam. Now Finesse going to move up and go real fast. Nice little crossfire there from Josh RT. Both holding that same angle. Zemphis will take him down. Going to smoke the site to try to get this plant. That took kind of a weird bounce. I don't think he wanted it to be quite there as he was trying to get over to the bomb and then just get the money. But unable to do so. Maka closing that off with the op. 13-6, and TSM back to the drawing board.
Of course, they won't really have too much invested in this round, given that the pattern of how the rounds usually play out. So XAA should be able to push a 7th round here before TSM can really pose much of a threat. But again, those Tech-9s, they can be a little bit dangerous to deal with, especially if TSM can close the distance and overwhelm like an individual player or something like that. As it looks like they're playing pretty default here for the most part. Automatic lurking over towards the B-bomb site, Sick and Vice both in the stairs. Memphis and Finesse both work in the park area.
Maka with that op. You know, I wouldn't have been able to tell it was an op if they didn't update the weapon silhouette. So I'm very glad that that was taken care of. Oh, Maka's in a difficult spot right now. Really no one able to cover his long, so he needs to get out of there in well timed. Memphis was just starting to creep up. Again, nothing's too dangerous. TSM just has pistols, but Zemphis did have a deagle, and if he got exposed from long, maybe could have been bad. And spotting two men at Monster. That is not the bomb, though. So can't really tell if it's a fake one way or the other, but they know that some are at A, and they know that some are at B. So it's just going to be up to XAA. No rotations, they just got to lock down the sights. Big Josh RT at A will fall. Happy Cheetos at Barrel, only able to get one now. He's going to go down. Here's Cutlass spraying. Six going to peek out. Maybe could have just planted the bomb. Oh, Cutlass running out of ammunition. What is this battle? Now there's something. They found it. Cutlass gets two headshots after what was a very awkward battle. Now Molly out onto the site. That'll delay Zemphis. And Cutlass finishes it off.
Why didn't he just plant the bomb? I'm so confused. There was really no immediate threat to stop him from putting
it down.
I think he was
going to try to surprise him. Like,
yeah,
oh,
I guess.
I'm planning, but now I'm peeking you. Then we've got number advantage.
But then
the
second
the
time he peeked,
but...
when he was, like, low HP and was, like, jumping up on top of the box, that was the weird
He
part.
Went a little overboard, yeah.
Like, I guess, like you said, the first fake plant peek was probably okay. Maybe you catch one off guard, get that kill. Maybe you actually set yourselves up to steal the round away. But that second time he jumped up with low health, that was real odd. Either way, we are going to be back to a full gun right here. Some of us will, in fact, have his op this time.
Yeah, on the T side, though, it might be a little harder to work with. Finesse getting pushed into the playground here. It's someone getting bullied on the playground? Is that what's happening? Finesse in some trouble back in a corner. The Molotov will buy him some space. Cutlass exclaiming that he just missed 20 bullets, so he knows that he did not perform very well in that exchange. Josh RT brings down automatic, and just like that, 3-on-3. Maka still holding pretty aggressive here at short, and somewhat in long is Sayonara. Tempest trying to find something.
They slowed it down. They do have a 3-on-3, and they were pretty successful at converting these in the first half from the other side of the map. You see pretty much all of TSM gathered up here over towards long A, working themselves up. They do have a good amount of time on the clock here. Maka and Sayonara, though, both here. Maka holding an angle on long with that op. So Symphys, I don't know if he'll just take the straight up duel or what. Oh, Maka does spot him, but Symphys has as well. Now Symphys has the angle, so this makes it really hard for Maka to just repeat. Tries to anyway with that flash. Both missed their shots. Now Maka has the angle, so just kind of a trading back and forth on who's holding who down at this point.
Oh, Maka!
NA incendiary.
That was an NA incendiary. Well put, Dust. FNS will find Maka after that. Sayonara, that's up! How do you lose that battle? The guy had 20 HP! Although Maka himself might have been low. Josh RT tried to go up. He'll take one man down, and that's it. I was getting kind of nervous. I mean, into a 3-on-3, how many times did we see XAA with that position on their T side, wait too long, and then fail to execute onto a site? It looked very likely that the same thing was going to happen to TSM, but they finally break through and get their first round here on the T side of Overpass.
Yeah, and XAA money real low here. They're going to do what they can. Maka will still have an op. They have some FAMASs out, so they're definitely going to be shorthanded here, and it'll be even worse next round if this doesn't work. So this is pretty much for the game. As far as XAA is concerned, they need to convert this one to stick in it, otherwise it would likely be 16-7 TSM moving on to their pick, which I believe was Mirage.
Correct.
You're going to see TSM just all as five, just pushing through long, Finesse leading the charge.
The death ball. And this can be very, very strong. They end up long uncontested. It's so hard to hold the A site when everyone just runs out this way. But lining up for the FAMAS of Sayonara, he grabs two quick ones now, switching out to the Dragon Lore. Gonna take some shots through the smoke, not connecting. I want to sit back and hold the angle, wait for those rotations. Josh RT flashing up, actually just flashes the crap out of his teammate. Happy Cheetos, meanwhile, though, is gonna catch off Vice, and that's coming down from the flank. Is still scoped in, nearly killing his teammate, but shooting through the dead body to land a shot on the Happy Cheetos, left in, I guess, a 1v4. Sees a man coming through the smoke. What is happening, Dust?
I mean,
if you took the names
just...
away, I think I just tuned into DMG matchmaking and the end of that round.
Well, to be fair, I know you said Symphys almost killed his teammate, but if you looked at it carefully, he actually... totally purposely didn't shoot and like remained patient.
No, yeah, I know.
And but didn't pull the trigger. Fine. So that was good. That time, for some reason, he just didn't want to unscope. And so when he got pushed so close like that, I mean, you flick and you hope that your scope makes it to the player, but it just didn't. And so it turns into one of those awkward close round pistol fights. It just didn't go into Timus's favor. So I'm not going to harp on him too much on that one. They really did kind of try just to force an issue, though. And a round that was kind of a force buy for XA. It's a little bit odd that you would choose to commit so heavily to a rush in that type of situation. Did not pan out, and now TSM will slow it down quite a bit.
Yeah, slow it down. That last round was chaotic. Now they'll slow it down, try to work a default here. They've got utility, mainly because automatic and finesse did not go for AKs. They took the Tech-9s to get the extra nades. And Team XAA, I mean, they're in a pretty tough spot to play really loose Counter-Strike just because they're up against the rope. So they're just holding on the sites defending, which means Team Solo mid doesn't really need to get the long or the map control as much as maybe if it were a closer series or a more dominant performance from XAA. They've already found their first pickoff though. Vice still waiting in the connector stairs. Happy Cheetos here on the site for XAA. Now Flash Cutlass taking his place. Moving up to the headshot ledge. He'll find automatic. Now they're getting pinched up. Molotov at the support call. Cutlass moves up, finds two more. Making a 3K before he dies. Finesse shooting a man out of the sky. Now 2-on-2. Nade, that's some big damage. But Maka alone. These guys are pretty low. Flash is going to go up, but it goes too far. That was to allow Finesse to cross. He does get across. Maka, he's only got flashes. He sees the shadow. Oh, last bullet. That could have been it. Now it gets dicey. 20 seconds on the clock. TSM's going for the kill. Sorry, TSM. Finesse is going for the kill.
What a hero.
That was such a gamble. But he gets a 4K and wins that round for his team.
Can't blame Finesse for gambling, though. With such low HP, he probably thinks that dude has a nade, and if I commit to a plan, I'm just dead. So he decides just to try to, you know, to push and make a play out of it, and he does. And he had several other really crazy kills that round as well. So that was really just a big individual effort for Finesse to save the round, and that might just win him the game because it resets XAA's economy. And you can see they're certainly struggling here. They just have some upgraded pistols. They have 1M4 on Sayonara. And we are going to see TSM going pretty heavy towards B here, just bicycle in the stairs. Everyone else trying to push short, but they're getting shut down.
An automatic bring it back. Needs to get that second kill, and does. Quick headshot onto Cutlass. Now 3-on-3. TSM on the T side will have that advantage. Also still a slight advantage. Actually, not really a slight advantage in weaponry. XAA with the AKM4 and a Deagle. There's two pistols and an AK for TSM, but here's Vice with that Tech-9, trying to break through that short drain. Now taken out. One dig from Maka. Two plays two. Automatic caught off in a smoke. Happy Cheeto on the low ground, able to see up under it. And now Semphis. Yeah, they just calmed out. They know where he is, but I don't know if he did. Semphis not checking down right. Happy Cheeto's able to win the round, and Team XAA, yeah, match or map point on the line on a force buy, are able to win it.
It doesn't strike me as odd that TSM would be so aggressive, because that's just kind of the style that Semphis has always had. And I know that Valens, their coach, is the main in-game leader, but they're very similar in their mentality from what I've heard from different people who have played with or have spoken with both of those guys. But to do it, both times they push on a force buy from XA and both times they lose, it just seems kind of counterintuitive to just kind of put all your eggs in one basket when you're up against like a force buying team who's going to be doing something crazy like that to gamble and try to win the round, you know? Maybe yeah. You avoid it. Maybe you push the right spot they're not stacked up on, but maybe you do. Like, it's like a 50-50 kind of thing.
Oh, Maka's only got a scout, which means Sick had armor because he survived that shot. So it looks like Sick was the only one that went in for armor. Everyone else not going for it. And that's just trying to cause some damage here. Get that CT economy as low as possible. You only got to win one more round. Try to give yourself a little bit better of a chance to do so. But so far, honestly, the T side from TSM has not looked very convincing. They've squeaked out, what, two rounds now? Both
yeah.
of those wins coming isolated.
They were a more standard round, though. It's like when they play from their default and they just like kind of work things out and get a little bit of map control and then just kind of like look for opportunities, they've done well. It's just literally the rounds that they've lost. I mean, obviously they lost Pistol in two rounds following that, so that was three of their round losses. But the other two were just, like I said, rushing into force buy stacks or force buy aggression. And I just don't think that's like a right way to play those types of rounds. But no matter what, they're still in a pretty good position to wind up winning this map. I mean, they have five rounds to put this away in regulation. They're hitting a point where they're going to start approaching a bigger money bonus. I mean, obviously, they have to save. If they lose this round, then it could be like 12-15. Then all of a sudden, you got to be a little bit concerned. So, I mean, this is kind of a big round, actually.
I would like to see TSM just able to slow it down, play a default, and win a round. I mean, I understand maybe they're thinking, all right, we're just better than this team. Let's just, you know, rush A, rush B, and win. But why rely on that? Why not just keep playing your defaults and be very confident in them, because that's what's going to be needed at the next level, right?
Yeah, I mean, like I said, there's no problem having aggressive rounds, just where they've placed them at has been a little bit odd, but they're going to go for another pretty heavy B push here. They don't have any presence at A or anything like that, but there's no aggression from XAA at the A bomb site, so they don't have this kind of information on what's going on just yet. Meanwhile, we do see Silamid, you know, methodically taking control of short now as well.
That must be a GoTV bug. There's like 400 cones in the window on my client.
Oh, wow. I don't have that.
Neither does our producer. That's sad. Heavy Cheetos gets that first kill and taking it real slow. And this isn't just a slow B take. Like, TSM have been standing outside of B for the first 50 seconds of the round with no map control. Like, you can't do that and expect to win a round. That flank comes down from construction so quickly.
That wasn't so much the problem. I think the real problem was is Finesse kind of went out there to do something, but then no one followed him up until much later Automatic came out of Monster. Sick and Company never really got up sandbags. So it seemed like they had the right idea. They were off on their time and they weren't synced up. They weren't on the same page, and that was the real big problem there. Now they're on a force buy, and this is where XAA can get it to 12. And then all of a sudden, now the comeback chance is really real at this point.
Yeah. They better sync up, because this map's about to go into the sink and then the garbage disposal.
In the bin?
Or in the bin, yeah, wherever you want to put it. As long as it's not that friendly of a place. This is looking pretty rough. Even still, they've got it to 3-on-3, but outgunned, out-armored right now, too. Automatic was able to pick up an AK and had Kevlar already, so that's the best chance on the round. Tempest is just trying to dry peek into A, brings out Happy Cheetos from behind Optimus. And here's Cutlass, man, maybe a shot. I know he's just shooting at the pixels of that head, but maybe a shot he should have had. And now Finesse has killed him from long. Maka trying to make that rotation up. 1v3, and now it doesn't really matter their armor. This man's just coming up with an op and alone. He's got a lot of nades to use, and if he throws one at Optimus, he can just get a free kill. He, of course, doesn't want to really just throw away his... The only advantage he has is they don't know where he's coming from. If he throws a nade, they do, but... I don't know. Very common to just toss nades right onto Optimus on retakes. He would have got that kill and then maybe had a better chance, but they do close it out. I will say, not super convinced on the T side from what we saw, but their CT side was good enough.
Yeah, I mean, for the purposes of this tournament, a W is a W, I guess, and so they got it. They did their job, and they won the game they were expected to win. But yeah, certainly when you're watching that T side, got to be a bit concerned, especially since they struggle on their T sides as well in all their other games. Like, they're two maps against Winter Fox and the LCQ. They're two maps against Renegades, where they played them on, I believe one of the maps was Kabul. I can't remember what the other one was off the top of my head, but in both those scenarios as well, they certainly struggled on the T side. I think it was Train, the other one there. So we've now seen them play five maps, granted only one time apiece, right? And in each case, we've really seen them just struggle. And this was even against a team that they shouldn't struggle against, right? So, and there's been a good month period of time between when we saw their debut in the LCQ and then this map we've seen so far tonight. So it certainly does leave a little bit of concern in the air. But nonetheless, they did get the job done. They will move on to map two of this best of three with them on map advantage.
Yeah, I still think there's an immense amount of concern in the air around TSM. We'll see how they do a little bit better on their map pick of Mirage. That's going to be coming up next year in the SIVO Gfinity Season 9 Pro League. This is North America. I'm Helium, with me Dust. We're going to throw it to a quick commercial break, but we hope you'll come back for map 2. And if needed, if Team XAA can strike back map 3. So we'll be right back.